Welcome back to Kids Church. We've been traveling around, and this week we are in Sugar Creek.
Hey, now that we're out and about, Fun Fat Guy is doing all kinds of crazy things.
That's right.
Wonder what he's going to do today.
Hang upside down from something else, maybe?
That'd be pretty fun. We'll have to see. This week we're going through Psalm 42 and 43.
That's right, and these psalms are a little bit sadder. They're not quite as upbeat as some of the other ones that we've looked at, but they teach us some really important things that we can learn so that when we feel sad, we know how to pray, because that happens all the time.
It sure does. You know, this psalm teaches us three things that we can do when we're feeling sad or even doubting God, but they can all be summed up with one word. Remember.
That's true. So what are the things that we have to remember?
Well, the first thing we have to remember is all the amazing things that God has done for other people through Bible stories.
That's right. And that's why we have to be really good at listening to our parents when they tell us the stories so that we can remember the things that God's done in the past so that we know that he's going to be good for us too.
Yes. So I know of a story that I'm thinking of that could help us with today's lesson, and it's in the book of Joshua.
I think I know what you're talking about.
Yeah. So in the book of Joshua, it's when the Israelites have come out of the Exodus, you know, the whole plagues parting the Red Sea.
Yeah, that was pretty amazing.
It was. But after they wandered in the wilderness for 40 years, they forgot about what God had done for them.
They forgot all of that, but it was so amazing. How could they forget?
I don't know. But they did, and here they are stuck at the Jordan River, and they don't know how to get across. And God comes through for them. Again.
Hang on. Does he do the same thing?
Yeah.
So he parts the Jordan River, right?
Mm-hmm.
And they walk through on dry land.
Yes. Once again.
That's awesome.
It's because God is the same in Moses' time.
Mm-hmm.
He's the same in Joshua's time. And he's the same today.
Right. And he treats us the same because he loves us. Because we're part of his family.
Absolutely.
Hey, kids. Fun Fact Guy here with guess what? Another fun fact. Even though David wrote a lot of the Psalms, he didn't write all of them. His worship leader, Asaph, he wrote some of them. And the people called the Korites, they wrote some of them. That's pretty cool to know that David wrote a majority of the Psalms, but he didn't write all of them. Some of his worship guys did. And that's the fact.
So the second thing that these Psalms teach us to remember is scripture, Bible verses.
Right. Which is why we've been memorizing Psalm 23.
That's right. Because when you memorize them, it's like you planted them in your mind. And then when you need them, they just pop up.
Which is awesome because we need to be able to remember the promises of God and the things that he's told us in his word so that we can know them. And fun fact guy, do you remember he told us what meditating really means?
That's right.
Because it's not sitting like this. No, he said that it's looking over verses and putting them in your heart and remembering them. So that's what we're doing.
That's right. Are there any scriptures in this particular psalm that David repeats over and over again?
Yes. He says, "Why am I downcast, O my soul?" Like three times. And then he follows it up with, "But I put my hope in God. For I will still praise him, my Savior and my God." And he repeats it three times.
We learned last week that when David repeats something in a psalm, it's important. It's something we should focus on. This would be a great verse for me to remember and to pray when I'm feeling downcast or depressed. Oh Lord, I put my hope in you. Because even though I'm feeling hopeless, I know you give me hope, my Savior and my God. Going back to our story of Joshua, there's a passage that is repeated over and over again throughout the entire book that God wanted his people to meditate on. Be strong and courageous, for I am with you wherever you go.
That is awesome. And that also reminds me of verse 4 in this psalm, because the writer is remembering what God has done and that God will give him strength.
So the third thing that we can remember is what God has done for us in our lives.
Correct.
So we can look back and see how God's been good to us before and will be good to us now.
Can you think of any times that you've done that maybe?
Yeah. So there was this time when I was a kid and I was feeling super lonely. Like I didn't have any friends around me. I remember literally crying out to God that he would give me some good friends. And you know what? I didn't tell anybody else about that prayer, just God. And a couple of days later, my neighbor invited me to go and hang out with her and her friends that weekend, and it led to some great friendships.
Whoa, that's awesome. He answered your prayer so quickly. Yes. And you could see his answer.
Absolutely. And so now when I'm feeling lonely, yeah, I can remember how good God was to me before and that he won't let me stay lonely for long now.
Right. And that reminds me of something that I like to do and that we see in the Bible too. And that's making rocks of remembrance. So like this one. Do you see?
Ah!
Do you see? It says, God in it all, be still. And it reminds me that God is always God, no matter what the circumstances around me are, and that I need to be still and listen to him.
So a rock of remembrance is actually something we see in the story of Joshua, right, as well. After God parts the Jordan River and they cross over onto dry land, Joshua sets up his own stones of remembrance, a pile of 12 big rocks that the Israelites can look back to whenever they're there and remember the amazing way that God provided for them there.
Hey kids, fun fact guy here down in the creek. And I got some stones around me, which reminds me of a fun fact. This is not the first time that in the Bible that stones were used to remember things. Samuel used a stone to remember a victory and he called it Ebenezer, but not Ebenezer Scrooge, like just Ebenezer. So that's the fun fact from the creek. I'll see you later. I'm gonna go take a swim.
So today we learned some things about who God is. And this psalm taught us three things that we need to remember. The first was that we can learn from Bible stories by remembering them. The second was that we can learn from memorizing scripture that will help us whenever we face situations in our lives. And the third was to remember what God has done for you in your life. And when you come to something that's similar again, think back on the things that he has done. Because God is still good, no matter what circumstances are around you.
Speaking of remembering, it's time to go over our Bible verses this week. Mm-hmm. And we're going to remember the first four verses of Psalm 23. So kind of put them all together. Mm-hmm. Now, we know that it's a lot easier to memorize verses when you put it to song. So in the link at the bottom of this video, you'll find a link to YouTube where they have a video of the Psalm 23 set to music. So if that's helpful for you to use, you can play that over and over again and get it stuck in your brain.
And maybe you'll even go further than where we are right now. Parents, don't forget to look out for the handout that's coming out for you with some discussion questions, and watch out for our videos. This week, we're gonna have the challenge coming out to you and a little follow-up video too. Apart from that, we'll see you guys next week, and we look forward to seeing you on social media using hashtag TBC Ohio Kids and @BranchChurchOH. See you guys next week.
Bye.